When we visit a website, we expect some kind of response when clicking or moving the mouse around. One great way to keep visitors engaged is by adding hover animations. These can range from simple icon effects to fancy 3D interactions. In this video, we're diving into a super simple icon hover animation with a smooth bounce effect. Stick around till the end for a couple of pro tips along the way. This is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. Before we jump into the CSS, let's first lay out the markup. We're using an unordered list as a wrapper for the social icons, and inside it, each list item will contain an anchor tag. For this example, I'm using the Font Awesome library, which is an easy way to get high-quality responsive icons. You can use your preferred icon system or even add SVG images directly into the HTML. As I promised at the beginning, it's time for the first tip of the day. Since there's no text inside the anchor element, maintaining accessibility can be tricky. In simple words, our social links only contain icons and no text to explain what they represent. That means screen readers won't be able to convey their purpose to users. In such cases, we can add the aria-label attribute with a clear description to enhance user experience. This will help screen readers understand what each link is for and announce that to the user. Let's update the rest of the links to follow this approach. Next up, if you've been following my CSS tutorials, you know I always like to start with some basic styles already set up for the project. Then we turn the UL element into a flex container. This will help keep all the list items perfectly aligned in a row. The flex basis property is used to control the size of items. After that, the anchor element inside each list item will also act as a flex container. Setting an aspect ratio of 1 ensures a perfect square by maintaining a proportional relationship between its width and height, without needing to specify exact dimensions. If the aspect ratio property is something new to you, check out this short video I made explaining how it works and how you can use it to create responsive layouts with ease. After applying a few more presentational styles, here's how it looks on the front end. All links are perfectly aligned with a transparent background and a solid circular border. Now, to create the fill effect, we'll use the after pseudo element. This will have an absolute positioning with a default background color, and to make sure it stays in relation to the parent element, we need to set the anchor tag's position to relative. The inset property with a value of 0 stretches the pseudo element to fill the entire space of its parent. Since we're creating a hover transition, we need to adjust its initial position to keep it hidden. So we set its top offset to 100%, while left, right, and bottom are all set to 0. It's like setting the width to 100%, but the height to 0. Then, in the hover state, the icon color changes to white, and the pseudo element's top offset moves from 100% to 0. But right now, if we hover over the icon itself ends up hidden behind the pseudo element. To fix this behavior, we can simply add a Z index to the icon to bring it in front of the pseudo element. Also, by adding overflow hidden to the anchor element, we make sure anything outside its boundaries stays invisible. Then the transition property will smooth out the changes, both for the icon color and the top offset of the pseudo element. This gives us a simpler version of the effect we're trying to achieve today. Now, let's take it a step further by adding a tooltip effect. We'll again use the after pseudo element, but this time on the list item. First, we'll add some dummy content, then position it with a top offset of -45%, set bottom and right to auto, and 50% from the left side. Then, to keep it center aligned, we'll apply the translate property with a horizontal offset of -50%. You can learn more about the inset property in this short video. While there are ways to add tooltips directly in CSS, I prefer keeping a clear separation between content and styling. That brings us to the second tip of the day, data attributes. Data attributes allow us to store extra information on standard, semantic HTML elements, without relying on hacks like non-standard attributes or mixing content with the CSS. By using data attributes, we can add a relevant tooltip to each of the social links. For example, this data tooltip attribute specifies the tooltip for Blue Sky, and we'll apply the same approach to the rest of the links. Now we can access these values directly in our CSS using the attribute function. This will retrieve the value of the data tooltip from the anchor element and use it as the value for the content property. After that, we can play with the opacity, visibility, and positioning. By default, the tooltip will stay invisible, and when hovering over the link, we'll adjust its top offset to -60%, along with changing its opacity and visibility. If you notice, I'm not using the hover state of the list item. Instead, the has pseudo class is used to detect when the child anchor tag is in the hover state, and only then will the changes be applied. If you've never worked with the has pseudo class, check out this in-depth tutorial to dive deeper into how it works. Then, the transition property is all we need to smooth out the effect. In case you don't know, instead of targeting all properties at once, we can split them up to apply different timing functions and durations. For example, in this updated version, the visibility transitions in 0.3 seconds, the opacacity takes 0.2 seconds, and the inset property transitions over 0.4 seconds with a customized cubic bezier to create a nice smooth bounce for the tooltip. By adjusting the timing function like this, we can easily add custom effects and make the transitions feel more polished. Next, if you want to go for a multicolor approach like we saw at the beginning of this video, that's totally possible. The straightforward way is to hard code all the colors directly in the CSS, but that can get difficult to maintain, especially in larger projects with multiple style sheets. Plus, you probably don't want other developers messing with your CSS. Let's dive into our third tip of the day. Instead of hard coding background colors for the pseudo elements, we can take advantage of custom properties. This CSS rule will read the custom property value directly from the element itself. If no custom variable named BG is attached, the default value from the CSS will be used. This same approach applies to another pseudo element defined with the anchor tag. The next step is to add the relevant colors to our social links in the HTML. An inline style on the li element will do the trick. This lets us assign any color we want for each social link individually. If you remember, we started with a tip on accessibility, so let's wrap up with another one. This hover interaction works well, but what if someone doesn't use a mouse and instead relies on keyboard navigation? To improve the experience for those users, we can add the Focus Visible pseudo class. With this small update, you'll see the same effect whether you're using a mouse or navigating through the keyboard. And that's how adding a little interaction can make a huge impact on user experience and improve overall engagement. I have another detailed video on the top 5 CSS properties I use in almost every project. Feel free to check it out. If you learned something new today, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more. Drop your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.